There's a common narrative around the running community out there that heel striking is bad. It causes theoretically high ground reaction forces when you strike the ground, which those high ground reaction forces can lead to injury, but also creates like a braking force. And that braking force could hinder your performance because we want to be as efficient as we can. So today we're going to discuss the science. Is heel striking really a bad thing? Does it hinder performance and will it increase your risk of injury? Welcome back, Run Smarter Scholars. Brody here with another video, this time to teach you about foot placement, heel strike, and essentially we're talking about the part of your foot that first makes contact with the ground when you run. Now, there's essentially three main categories. You have your heel strike, you have your midfoot, which is kind of the entire foot hitting the ground at the same time, and you also have a forefoot strike. Now, the research usually categorizes those three, but it's really across a wide spectrum. For instance, you could be classified as a heel striker, but have a really far forward aggressive heel strike, whereas others that are heel strikers could be a really subtle heel strike. As well as the midfoot and forefoots, you can be on a mild side or you could be on the real aggressive side. So it really is across a really broad spectrum. Now, how you can determine exactly what category you fit into, because sometimes just trying to gain a sense while running, people are quite inaccurate with that. So you can film yourself in slow motion and to see which part of the shoe makes contact first. Or like the video I did talking about step width, you can just look underneath your shoe. And unless you do a lot of walking in your shoes, this could be a really nice telling tale. If you're a heel striker, most of the wear and tear will be around the heel. If you're midfoot, it should be around here, or have like a lot less wear and tear just because it's very evenly placed. But if you're a forefoot striker, it should be contained at the forefoot of the shoe. Okay, before diving into the science of injury risk and performance, I thought I'd share a paper on the prevalence of what type of foot strike everyone else is. And I found a great paper from Peter Larson, so let's dive into that now. So Larson and colleagues conducted this study where they observed 936 distance runners. They classified as recreational or sub-elite in their ability. They looked at them in the marathon at the 10 kilometer point and at the 32 kilometer point and just observed all of them, what their right foot did, what their left foot did, and classified them within these three contact points. Surprisingly, they found that rear foot strikers, the overall percentage was 88.9%. They also said our results indicate that rear foot striking was significantly more common at 32 kilometers than it was at 10. So this would signify that as people are getting more fatigued, if they were a midfoot or a forefoot at the start of the race, as those fatigue patterns develop, they just slowly transition into more of a rear foot strike, which is heel striking. Now we know how prevalent it is, what can the science say in terms of rate of injuries? I found a paper by Chris Napier. The title was Kinetic Risk Factors of Running-Related Injuries in Female Recreational Runners. And they studied 65 participants and had a look at their analysis, had a look at how they're running, and then looked at their injury rates afterwards. And this paper found that peak braking force was the only kinetic variable that was a significant predictor for running-related injuries. Interestingly, they took all these participants and kind of bunched them into three main groups and had tier one making the least amount of braking force, and then they had tier three of those creating the most braking force, and then tier two in the middle, and they discovered participants with the greatest braking force, tier three, were injured at five times the rate of those in tier two, and almost eight times the rate of those in tier one. So this is a clear paper to show that peak braking force is really important when it comes to reducing your risk of injuries, but we should be very careful and not assume that all heel strikers have a large braking force. Because like I said earlier, it all fits on a spectrum. Someone who has a large aggressive heel strike, they might have a large braking force, but you can still contact with your heel underneath your body and create less of a braking force. So while the theory holds up that yes, heel striking may create a braking force, it's not necessarily true for every runner. So next is the discussion around efficiency. Well, if we go back to that Larson paper that observed all those runners during that marathon, They mentioned in their conclusion that among marathon runners, we found no significant relationship between foot strike patterns and race times. So while this is only one little study, we can then move across to something a little bit more robust. The next paper I want to draw our attention to is a large systematic review and meta-analysis. The title was, "What are the benefits and risks associated with changing foot strike pattern during running?" They looked at injury, running economy, and biomechanics. Like I say, this was a large study. They got 53 studies and compiled all of the data and see what they found and tried to come up with some conclusions. And they found in their conclusions that there just wasn't much research to point in one direction or another. And they concluded, considering the lack of evidence to support any improvements in running economy, combined with associated shift in loading profile, changing strike patterns cannot be recommended for an uninjured rear foot striking runner. And some of the reasons why they didn't find changes in economy, I wanted to draw your attention to one of my favorite papers. It's by Dr. Izzy Moore, and it's all about running economy. And in the paper, she mentions that the findings show no difference in running economy between rear foot and forefoot striking at slow, medium, and fast speeds. It continues to say, however, others have shown rear foot striking to be more economical than midfoot striking at slow running speeds. Interestingly, habitual forefoot strikers can change to a rear foot strike without negatively affecting their running economy. However, if you change your foot strike pattern from a rear foot to a forefoot, this produces worse running economy at slow and medium speeds. And what they found in this paper was if you go from a heel strike to a forefoot strike, you're essentially trying to make a large adjustment, moving away from your most efficient, most effective running style that suits you. And to make a change has a metabolic cost. To do something different, to do something you're not used to, takes up a lot of energy rather than your most fluent stride. But the science will show that the risks and the struggles in economy to get there, if you were to go from a heel strike to a forefoot strike, the evidence just shows that there's no changes, there's no significant difference in running economy, so making that change is probably not worth it. Okay, Run Smarter Scholars, I just have one takeaway from today's episode. Heel striking is fine. In fact, the vast majority of runners are heel strikers. There may be some risk of injury, but it is only if you display an aggressive heel strike really far in front of your body and creating that braking force. But you can still be a heel striker and contact close to underneath your body, and you'll be fine with your injury rates and your economy. If you find that you do have an overstride and contacting with the heel and creating that braking force, increasing your cadence by 5 to 10% should correct that. That's all today. If you really enjoy these videos on running technique, I've done two more videos that you can check out. If you have liked or learned anything in this video, hit like so I know that I'm doing a good job. If you have any questions about technique, foot strike, or shoe wear and tear patterns, leave it in the comments below. I'll be sure to answer them.